What's up, LC? Welcome back to your second installment of LCTV. I'm Greta Siegert.
And I'm Matt Santana. And on this week's episode, we'll be learning about some new information on the homecoming dance.
Meeting Sam Halloran.
And seeing who can try not to laugh.
For our first current news, schools locally discourage students from joining a national TikTok trend, Devious Licks.
Students across the U.S. are being arrested from participating in TikTok trend, Devious Licks. Principal Aaron Novak announced that students who take part in this trend will receive disciplinary consequences, including suspensions, police action, and reimbursement for damage.
I think the Devious Licks trend is childish, and destroying school property is not the right thing to do.
This weekend is homecoming. Let's check in with some LC students and teachers on what they're planning.
Hi, my name is Ethan Knopf. I'm a senior this year, and I will be attending homecoming, but I'm going with friends.
Hi, my name is Olivia Enyer. I'm a sophomore, and I'm really excited for homecoming since this will be my first dance. I'm going with Grant Myers, and I'm ordering my dress online because I heard stores don't have very much in them this year. He asked me with balloons, and he wrote homecoming on them, and it was really cute because when I walked in the door, he had them.
My name is Nadia Clayton. I'm in 10th grade, and I got my homecoming dress from White Iris. It's white, tight, and it's sparkly. For homecoming, I don't really know what to expect because it's my first one. I just hope to have fun and then afterwards have fun. For pictures, I don't really know where I'm going to take them and I don't know who I'm going with.
My name is Kylie Connor and I'm a senior this year. I'm super thrilled to be attending my last homecoming. I'm going with Mateo Cortez. I got my dress from A Pink Boutique. It's blue, sparkly, and a one-shoulder dress. I participated in Spirit Week, and my favorite theme was 80s theme.
I'm so excited for this Saturday. Don't forget, doors open at 6.
An LC student worked hard on creating a new club called MAP. Let's go check it out with Kimmy.
Hello, my name is Kimberly Hesterman, and I'm a senior at Lake Central High School. I created the Mentorship Ambassador Program the end of my junior year with the help of Mr. Bagley and Ms. Stanford. So the Mentorship Ambassador Program is basically a reinvented version of the mentorship program that exists in my freshman year, and we already ran and planned Freshman Rush that happened in August. We're also going to go visit the middle schools to kind of give our insight as upperclassmen, as this club is for juniors and seniors, and we also help out at open building, open house for the parents, and parent night as well. So for open house, we were able to get a lot of volunteers from the MAP program to come help, and we've basically just been helping out the parents who look lost and directing them to the classrooms as they're walking their kids' schedules. I would definitely recommend any juniors or seniors who are interested in gaining leadership skills to join this organization or club because it really allows you to get more involved in your community, in your school. We have lots of leadership positions as well as you move up. And if you want to join, contact Ms. Klein or Ms. Holden because those are our sponsors.
MAP looks like really something fun to be a part of. If you're interested in joining, go talk to Kimmy about it.
Have you seen our students? Section this year, let's go talk to some of the boys and see what it's all about.
Hi, my name is Aiden Kluth, and I'm this year's student section leader. So I knew Sam Long, our last Indian, for a couple years. We played intramural basketball last year together, and at his grad party, he announced me as Indian. It was completely unexpected. I was super stoked.
My name is Malik Smothers.
My name is Jacob Noldeen, and we help out with the student section.
My favorite thing about the student section is personally getting everybody hyped, like running through the crowds, just putting a smile on everybody's faces and everything.
We all help out with the chants. We spread out and all yell the chants at the same time, try to get everybody involved. It's all good time.
And you want a devil out of that? Yeah.
So my goal for this year is to just try to get as many students as possible, do as many games as possible, and create that energy that the players and everybody involved with the team loves and So just getting the underclassmen ready for when they're juniors and seniors, just to create that best atmosphere possible, blowing all the other student sections out of the water. It's always fun. Some of my favorite things to do are starting the chants, getting involved with the cheerleaders, hyping them up. We like doing things at halftime when we have some downtime. We got the roller coaster. Our dance team only performs at halftime. We like to hype them up. Our cheer team still does their thing. So everyone's welcome at the tailgates. I'll tweet out times like that. We need everybody there. We need everybody to get to the games, pack the house. Follow us on our Twitter at LC Fan Section. I'll be posting on there more and more, just game updates and themes, game times, stuff like that.
We're happy to lead you guys in the student section this year.
We expect to see every single one of you this Friday at the homecoming game.
Pop out, let's get lit.
Yes, sir.
I'm super excited to lead this year and represent Lake Central in the fan section. I hope everybody has a good time.
Be sure to follow at LC Fan Section on Twitter for all your game updates.
Let's go talk to Emily in Brooklyn about Interact Club's current
fundraiser.
Hi guys, my name is Brooklyn Winchell.
And I'm Emily Lopez, and we are co-presidents of Interact Club. So Interact Club is pretty much a community-based club, so we do a lot of community services projects. So sometimes we do stuff as simple as making cards for veterans or nursing homes, and then other times we do fundraisers, and all the money we get, we always source it back out to the community. So for example, if we raise money with a certain donation, then we'll give that money to the Women's Abuse Shelter or hospitals, local hospitals, and other good programs that are helping our community.
Our club is having a fundraiser for the Afghan refugees that are coming to the U.S. And more close to home, these refugees are being stationed at Camp Atterbury in southern Indiana. There's about 6,000 of them, and they could really use our help. Our donation starts September 20th, and it's going to go all the way to October 25th. And things we're looking for are clothes, hygienic items, baby items, water, cases of water. If you're interested, there's flyers in room C313, that's Tom Clark's room. And if you donate, donations will be taken there as well. We're looking for new items, but if you do bring gently used items, we'll take those, but just not directly to that facility since they're scared of COVID.
I think that this fundraiser is so important to participate in and to donate to because these refugees are coming over to the United States because back when we were at war and we were stationed in Afghanistan, they were helping our military and our mission out there. So now they're at risk in their own home country because of for helping us. So I think that now it's time for us to return the favor and help them. They left their countries with nothing, and the least we can do is donate cases of water or hygienic products just to help them out. So if you guys have any questions about the donation or Interact in general, you can email me or Brooklyn at our LC student emails. Thank you.
Remember, you can donate in room C313.
Let's head over to Katie and Kelsey for this week's sports update.
What's up, LC? Welcome back to this week's edition of Sports Update. I'm Katie Odrobanak.
And I'm Kelsey Moore.
Let's roll into it. This past weekend, our girls' soccer team dominated Concord in a morning win 3-0. The three goals were scored by Layla Dureski, Ava Gutman, and Erin Mutter. Great job on the win, girls, and good luck in your upcoming games. Also over the weekend, our boys' soccer team traveled to North Central where they defeated them in a tight matchup 1-0. The boys look to improve on their 5-0 DAC record with a big game against Valpo next week. Good luck, boys.
Our girls' volleyball unfortunately lost to Valpo this past week with a score of 0-3. They look to get back on track this week playing Michigan City and Portage.
Our girls' golf team competed in their sectional this past weekend. The girls placed third as a team and advanced to the regional next weekend. Good luck, girls.
The boys' tennis won the battle of the wooden racket at Lowell High School this past week for the third consecutive year. Good job, boys.
The football team unfortunately lost in an overtime thriller to LaPorte last week, 20-27. The boys are back at home this week for a homecoming game against Michigan City. Game starts at 7. Make sure you come out and support the boys.
I'm gonna fight them all. I'll save the nation, I'll make it.
Hey Katie, do you know a girl played on the LC hockey team?
No, I had no idea. Let's go check it out.
I wanted to try out for the LC hockey team because I wanted to do something for LC because I didn't do it my freshman year. I was kind of mad about that. So I was like, okay, let's just try out. Let's like give it a shot. The position I play is defense. On defense, you stop them from coming in to try to score a goal and you have forwards help. Being a girl on the LC hockey team is actually kind of fun because it's fun talking to all of them and they're all super fun and nice and they like, yeah, they're good about everything. Like it's pretty normal.
What made me want to try out for LC hockey is being a part of like a brotherhood where we like all come together and like play as a team and basically just play the game that we all love because we all have something in common and we just bond over that. I play center and left wing. What center is, basically you're the leader on the ice, you're making plays, you're just trying to score, put the puck in the net, but also play defense so they don't score on you. Left wing, it's the same thing as right wing, but on the other side of the ice where you just try to score and they're more of an offensive. Honestly, it's pretty fun. I like being a girl on the LC hockey team because, I mean, we get a lot of respect just because we are like brave enough to go play with a bunch of big guys, and I mean, it's pretty intimidating. But once you get to know them, they're really nice and they like respect you.
It's great to see that girls can roll the hockey rink too. That's it for this week's Sports Update, LC. I'm Katie Odrobinek.
And I'm Kelsey Moore.
We'll see you next time.
Thanks, Katie and Kelsey, for that awesome sports update.
Let's see who could try not to laugh.
I'm Callie Schuster, and I'm a freshman.
I'm Sydney Petrovich, and I'm a sophomore.
And we're the girls' team.
My name is Alexei Josefsky, and I'm a sophomore.
I'm Riley Petrovich, and I'm a sophomore.
And we're the boys' team.
We got this.
Yeah, we can do
we're
this.
Their jokes are literally so bad.
They're doing Fortnite dances over there.
I'm not gonna laugh. I mean, it's Sydney. How funny can she be?
Yeah, they take L's.
I have a fear of speed bumps. How do you throw a space party?
How?
You plan it. Do you know who Joe is?
Who?
Joe Mama.
Three tomatoes are walking down the street, Papa, Mama, and Baby Tomato. Baby Tomato starts lagging behind. Papa Tomato gets angry and walks up to Baby Tomato and steps on him and says, ketchup. Why do we tell actors to break a leg?
Why?
Because every play has a cast.
What did the shark say when he ate the clownfish? This tastes a little funny. Why do Fortnite gamers have great teeth? Because they love to floss.
No.
Did you hear about the actor who fell through the floor? He was just going through a stage.
Why did the frog take the bus to work today? His car got towed away. I got my daughter a fridge for her birthday. I can't wait to see her face light up when she opens it.
We had some tough competitors, but in the end, I'm pretty sure who won was obvious.
Yeah.
Us.
It's okay, really.
How did we lose? The other team so saw us.
It's okay, really.
Oh my God.
What is Forrest Gump's password?
Hey, what about this one?
Alexei, you're so sussy. We said no Among Us jokes, my guy.
Oh, my bad.
Wow, that was hard not to laugh.
I think 80s was definitely the best theme.
I think it was Western.
No, it was definitely 80s. Let's watch some LC students bicker like me and Matt.
What's up, LC? Today we are debating the world's hardest questions.
First up, a suit. Two students go head-to-head and play rock, paper, scissors to decide which side of the debate they'll be on. Welcome to the dumbest debate you'll ever see.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Cereal is not a soup.
Okay.
Cereal is not a soup because it needs to be cooked.
Well, you could cook cereal. It just wouldn't taste as good, but you could cook it.
It needs to be in broth.
Not all the time. Yeah.
All the time?
No, I didn't even think of that. He stole my point. He stole my point.
How does that defend your point?
Okay, when you think about it, milk equals broth, okay? Chicken noodle soup has chicken,
how is
noodles.
Milk broth?
Is it a liquid? Yes. Equal, boom. Anyway, chicken noodle
equal
soup.
Boom.
Yes, chicken noodle
yes.
soup has chicken, noodles, and vegetables. Lucky Charms
cereal
has cereal and marshmallows. Boom. You.
I don't know what to say.
See? I'm better. Cereal is a soup.
For this round, the winner, Dylan.
Let's go.
No! Cereal is a soup.
It's not a soup.
It's a soup.
Okay. Nope. Our next topic is a hot dog a sandwich?
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Let's go. Okay.
Hot dogs are not a sandwich.
Hot dogs are a sandwich.
Okay.
Hot dogs are a sandwich.
Hot dog is not a sandwich because, for the first reason, it needs to be in between two breads.
A hot dog is between two breads. Those breads just happen to be combined.
It's one bread.
No, but think about Subway. Think about Jimmy John's. It's not two. It's a sub. It's one
well,
combined.
It needs to have more than just meat. It needs cheese.
You ever heard of a chili cheese dog? Chili
it's
cheese.
Not a sandwich.
It is a sandwich. As things mix together, put the two breads together, something in the middle, it's a sandwich. Sandwich. Hot dog. Are you hearing the same words? Sandwich, hot dog. Same thing. You can think.
For the winner for this round is once again Dylan.
You know it.
Dylan? Dylan? My name is Jada. You got that confused. A hot dog is a sandwich. Cereal is a soup. Dylan? I'm done. I'm done. Let's go, Dylan. You want to take this outside?
Whoa. I definitely would have won that debate. Well, that's all for this week, Elsie. I'm Greta Seeger.
And I'm Matt Santana.
Peace!